Hi, I'm Dave Owens, your garden guy. Hey guys, we're at Summer Winds Nursery. I just want to show off some of the plant material I've utilized for a long time. Here's some, well, bougainvillea. Bougainvillea work out well out here in the desert southwest. Don't put these guys around pool. They got a brack on them, Senator poinsettias. This is the true flower right in the middle here. Off to the side, well, this is all the protective element, and this is what you're looking for. But you see how well these guys do. Now, this is a plant that the worse you treat it, the better he does, the better he blooms. For invariably, people have a tendency to overwater them and over-fertilize these guys. So by cutting off the waters, you create a lot of flowering. By going ahead and not fertilizing it, again, you create a lot of flowering. So you gotta keep that in mind when you're keeping these guys around. Again, fairly dirty, so you want to keep it in one of those areas that doesn't have an area like a pool or something you need to keep clean. Another one, Cape honeysuckle. They can grow as a bush or even a vine like this, and this is one that attracts a lot of those hummingbirds. Easy to grow out here in the desert southwest. It is one of those plants that will get a little bit of frost tender, as does the bougainvillea, so you got to keep that in mind. Up against walls, especially south facing, where you've got a lot of thermal mass, this is one that will work out real well for you. So you can plant it up against that wall, south facing. Again, it absorbs a lot of sunlight, as does the needs of a bougainvillea, and that sunlight will radiate that heat back into it during the nighttime. So you got to keep that in mind when you're planting a lot of these plants. Let's talk about a few others that you want to think about out here. And we put this on Thursday, but this is the Lady Banksia rose, or Banksia rosea. This is one that will bloom and bloom profusely this time of year. So if you want a rose that will hold up real well, comes in yellow or white and doesn't really require a whole lot of fertilization. So you want to keep that in mind when you're planting this. These are all easy plants to grow, give you a lot of flowers. Not quite indigenous here to Arizona, but all low water use, sometimes known as a tombstone rose. And if you want a low-lying type of vegetation and you want something that will hold up fairly well, gets a little bit of white flag damage, yellow lantana. Here it is right here. Comes in several different varieties or several different colors. The yellow happens to be one of my favorites. Now, we talked about white flies. If you got white fly damage, you might want to try some yellow sticky traps or even, well, some of your different types of parasitic wasps to get rid of them. But really, just a washing down with water will go a long ways to protecting your plants from those white flies. As soon as it cools down in September, October, normally they're going to be in real good shape and you don't have to worry about it. But again, this is one that we utilize, and we utilize quite a, well, utilize around your garden areas, everything, as a trap type plant. And you can see the different varieties that you're growing along here. And let's talk about one last one, and this is not quite on the, well, it's not quite the non-desert, it's more of a desert variety, but this is an Angelita daisy. This is one that you can utilize during the summer for those flowers, and it works out well in pots or even in the ground. This is a one that's not, well, it's not basically native to our area, but it does grow in our dry, rocky soils out here, and it does very well, again, without a whole lot of care. Fairly drought tolerant, easy to care for, and you're gonna be on your way. So those are some of the plants I've utilized in my desert landscape for a long time, and it's something you might wanna try in your own landscape.